presentation, I'm going to speak about structures which are subjected to cyclic folding and their computational method, which is, along with numerical methods, nowadays is widely spread in order to determine their type of asymptotic behavior of the structure. It is the incremental, the method is the incremental loading in simulia abacus and the finite element method, of course. Then some words about results, their generalization and normalization would be said. For elements of structures which work in real conditions, they are always subjected to different temperatures and loadings. And so methods that and approaches that can provide us the way to determine the state of the structure are nowadays very popular and we need them. It is well known that for structures, for elastic plastic structures, there are three types of behavior, asymptotic behavior. It is shakedown, cyclic plasticity, and rigidity. Shakedown is the most safe and preferable one. So the structure behaves elastically after a finite number of cycles. Rigidity, you should avoid rigidity in structural design, as it leads to fracture because of accumulating of plastic strain. In this particular work, the structure was considered a simple structure, a square plate with an elliptical central core. The plate is constituted of an elastoplastic material. Loading is subjected in pairs to the one side of the plate, subjected to the cyclic loading, and the other to the other side of the plate is static, subjected to static pressure. you can see the loadings in the graph. So P1 is static one, and P2 is T periodic sinusoidal function. Because of the structure is, we can consider only a quarter of the plate. During our investigations, we computed the results for three different materials. It is copper, but three different types: solid, hand-drawn, cold-drawn, and annealed copper. Material data you can see in the slide. All computations were made in simulia abacus. They were made for 30 cycles. And when 30 cycles were not obvious to determine the state of the of the structure, the number of cycles was increased up to 60 or more. All the my pictures graphs are for 30 cycles. The amplitudes of loads were varied in different parity in order to determine the domains when the structure behaves the same way. And during this investigation, some results were obtained, and I'll show them now to you. For example, here we can see that the cyclic nature of stress in each cycle, for three different states. The blue curve is for shakedown, green curve is for cyclic plasticity, and the red one is for rigidity. Here you can see how the structure behaves when it is when the state of the synthetic behavior is shaped down. So plastic strain stochastical up to a finite number of cycles. In certain patterns and levels of loading, plastic strain changes its sign at each cycle. So total strain is not very high, and this behavior, this phenomena is called cyclic plasticity. And here you can see some examples of it. And for certain patterns and levels of loading, plastic strain accumulates, so it doesn't change the sign, and so deformations become plastic strain at all become very high, and so it leads to the collapse of the structure. And here you can see the representation of it, of this behavior. These graphs were made for strain stress dependence, and here you can see all these three types of behavior which were classified earlier. Now you can see the plastic flow, which is obvious in the plate. And then the structure collapses. This is bridged. All the computations were collected, and then this graph was made, where you can see the domains of required loadings, which are made for this or that type of behavior. This is the graph for copper type 1. So you can see the boundaries of the domains when structure behaves elastically. It is green. When structure behaves, the behavior is cyclic plasticity, it is blue. And the other lobes lead to rigidity. This graph is convenient in order to determine the loads which you can apply to the structure, and it will be safe. It is obvious from the graph. And the same was made, figures were made for other types of material. This one and this one. Now they all together. We see that for different materials, numerical results are different, but they all have the same shape. Yes, thank you. So we started to think about how to normalize these results. Maybe they will come together some way. And the normalization occurred to be simple after some investigations. We considered dimensionless parameters P1, which is the loading P1 to CMP, which is material outer strength material, and P2 soil world, it was made of ground, so I can, we can view it to the outside. So in conclusion, I should say that in this work, was it executed, it integrated the big series of computer modeling experiments of the plate, which was subjected to cyclic loading. Dependence of the asymptotic behavior of the structure and the plate loads was determined and generalized and normalized for different materials. And at last, a convenient normalization of numerical results is offered, and we can use it to determine the state of the plate without computing the whole series of the experiments. The obtained results may be used to check the results of direct methods, different direct methods, which would lead to design and projection